Good morning. Welcome to The Wire. This is Zoe. Hope you had a great weekend. Let's get started with the birthdays for the week. Here's Valentina with the birthdays.
Our birthdays this week are Audrey, Maria, Colton, and Maria. Happy birthday, everyone. Have a good one and a good luck on another year of your life.
It's always good to spread kindness. Here's Cheyenne to share a kindness shout-out.
Hi, Niran. This kindness shout-out is for Audrey and Leanne from Miss Claire. Leanne helped a friend find her way to the office while she was gone. She missed a couple of things in her class. Audrey stopped what she was doing and helped Leanne catch up. Thanks for being such kind friends, ladies.
It's about time for a good laugh. Zane's got you covered with the joke of the week.
Hi, Niran. It's me, Zane, and I'm going to be here to do the joke of the week. And the joke of the week is, what do you call a story about a broken pencil? Pointless. And wait a minute, is this my pencil? Wait, where'd the pencil let go on here? Wait a minute, how am I supposed to do the homework? Broken pencil alert!
Now it's time for our weekly message from the principals.
Hi everybody, it's Mrs. Schwanke
and Mrs. Nicholson.
We're outside because we're super excited. It started to feel a little bit like spring. And next week is actually spring break. So we won't see you guys for a whole week, but when you come back from spring break, it'll actually really look a lot like spring. So a little bit more green,
yep.
Maybe even see some flowers.
Some daffodils, my favorite. Yep. So have a great week, everyone. Have a great spring break. And remember,
what begins here will change the world.
Thank you, Mrs. Schwanke and Mrs. Nicholson. Guess what time it is? That's right, it's Indian Runs Got Talent. Our talented student today is Bradley from Mrs. Berger's class. Enjoy!
Hello, my name is Bradley, and I'm playing a toy. I'm gonna take my horse to the ocean world.
Well done, Bradley. If you're having a bit of a rough day and need something inspiring to lift your spirits, we have just the thing for you. Here's Thierno with positive quotes.
You are amazing just the way you are. If you see someone and thought a smile, give them one of yours.
Nobody wants to be stung by a wasp, and people usually flee at the sight of them. But have you ever wondered what a wasp nest looks like and how they make it? Here's a special science report about this fascinating creature.
Hi, I'm Dean Ren. This is Rakaya.
And Vivian.
And we're doing a special report on the bald-faced hornet.
This is a bald-faced hornet's nest. Isn't it huge?
Did you know that this nest can grow bigger than a basketball?
These wasps are also known as the bald hornet, white-faced hornet, blackjack, white-tailed hornet, spruce wasp, black jacket, and boll wasp.
This species of yellow jacket wasp is not a true hornet. This is what a bald-faced hornet looks like. This little thing can be very painful.
Unlike bees, a bald-faced hornet repeatedly stings, which can cause you to go to the hospital because their stingers are filled with venom.
The bald-faced hornet's nest is made out of paper and saliva chewed up to be spun out into a nest, almost like a spider, but it doesn't make a web, it makes a nest.
When the winter and fall come, the hornets leave the nest and never come back to it. They just find new materials to make another nest for the spring and summer.
Shout out to Mr. Miller for cutting this down from his tree.
If you guys are interested in seeing this nest, just ask your teachers to email Mr. Miller and we can come to your classroom and you can see the nest up close.
We hope you learned something new about the bald-faced hornet. Goodbye!
Finally, many of our families at Indian Run are going to celebrate a holiday coming up called Holi, and Sage is going to share some info about it.
Today I'll be telling you about cool things that happened this week in history. March Madness has started. It's a college basketball tournament, which happens every year in March. This year is the 81st year of the tournament.
Woo, yes!
Bat shot, knock my socks off!
Did you know that this week, back in 1848, Niagara Falls had no water because a thick ice blocked the river from flowing and made an ice dam? Usually there's over 600,000 gallons of water that rush over falls every second. That's about 600,000 of these every second! Another thing that's happening this week is Holi. Holi is a Hindu festival that is celebrated by many people around the world and takes place every spring. It's often called the Festival of Color because after the bonfire the night before, the next day, people have fun by attending parties or filling the streets by throwing colored powder at each other. Have fun this weekend, Inan. Bye!
Thank you everyone for watching. Stay safe, choose kind, make it a task to wear your mask. Wash your hands, greet your friends, and we hope this Wired episode was great. That's all for today. For The Wire, this is Zoe signing off. Don't forget to be kind, be respectful, and be amazing. Make it a great week, Indian Run. Bye.